In this tutorial, we're setting up the Cloud Store Mini. The procedure is the same for both the pod and the regular Cloud Store. The Cloud Store provides ultra-fast SSD storage that can be accessed directly via USB or over a network. Connecting via the network allows multiple users to access the Cloud Store simultaneously, and it also allows you to upload and download to cloud services such as Dropbox or Google. Here on the back, you can see the 10 gig and 1 gig Ethernet connection and USB connection. I'll start with USB-C. Once connected, it appears as a location in Finder, or if you're on Windows, it will show up in Network. And just like that, it's ready for you to start working. It works the exact same way with the network connection. There are two network ports. This one is capable of speeds up to 10 gig, and this one is speeds up to 1 gig. Today, I'm going to use the 1 gig. Just as before, the Cloud Store appears as a location in Finder. It's as straightforward as that. You can get to work straight away, and anyone else connected to your network has access to the Cloud Store immediately. There are settings that you can configure for your Cloud Store. To do that, you'll need to install the Cloud Store Setup app, available from Blackmagic Design's website. It will automatically detect your Cloud Store, whether you are connected via USB or over a network. This page shows basic usage information for the Cloud Store. Clicking this button allows me to adjust settings. I can set things like its name, time zone, and IP address. The Cloud Sync tab allows you to connect your Cloud Store to a cloud service like Dropbox or Google Drive. You could use this feature to back up your data or share the material with a remote colleague. All that they'll need is their own Google or Dropbox account. Maybe they have their own Cloud Store. They can use Cloud Sync to synchronize all the material onto their own local Cloud Store. If their internet connection is slow, you might choose to only synchronize proxy media. Finally, on the back of the Cloud Store, there's an HDMI connection. Connect it to a screen and you'll get this rather pretty interface that shows drive usage, connected users, the status of any Cloud Syncs, and individual stats for each connection. I have been using the Cloud Store Mini as my main editing drive. I keep it connected to my computer via USB for the fastest speeds, and it's also on my network, so I have accessibility on a variety of computers. I hope you liked this tutorial. If you did, give it a like and subscribe for more.